Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I am the owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. I am a financial controller and a QuickBooks supervisor, helping nonprofits to increase profitability one mission at a time. In this tutorial, I will explain how to use the sales center and how to create donors, members, and customers in QuickBooks Online. To access the Sales Center, click on the Sales tab at the left navigation bar. Here you will see your five main tabs of the Sales Center at the top. Clicking on the Overview tab, this shows you quick shortcuts to creating sales transactions in QuickBooks Online. You can create invoices from here. If you have not done so, you could track the status of your payments on this screen. The All Sales tab shows all of your sales transactions such as payments, sales receipts, invoices, and credits. The top bar that you're seeing on my screen is called the Money bar. This bar, if you click on any one of the tabs, it will filter your overall sales transaction list. It will filter it to that particular bar transaction. So if you click on unbilled activity, you will only see transactions for unbilled activity. If you click on the overdue invoices, you will only see invoices that are overdue. If you click on open invoices, you will see invoices that are open. And if you click on paid last 30 days, you will see invoices or sales receipt that has been paid within the last 30 days. The Invoices tab shows you invoices only with the number of days past due. So this is where you get to track the status of your invoices to determine which one has been paid and which one has not been paid, and which one have you received payments on, and when did you receive payments on those. The Customer tab shows you your customer list with a money bar at the top of the page to filter the list. Here you can see customer names, company names that you have entered into QuickBooks Online. You can see the phone number that you have entered. You can see open balances for each customer. If you click on the gear icon at the top right hand corner, you can add more columns like the address, the email, customer type, the attachments column, so you can add additional columns to see more information in this screen. Under the action column, you can perform similar transactions such as receiving payments to an invoice or to create an invoice or to send a reminder for a customer to pay an invoice, to create statements, create sales receipts, you could create estimate. You can pretty much complete the same action that you are able to complete using the quick create plus icon button. You can complete those same transactions inside of the customer center. Switching to the products and services center, here is where everything that you sell for your nonprofit or ways that you collect your money in your nonprofit, this is where all of those items and all of those services will be listed in QuickBooks. We are going to create a new customer in QuickBooks Online. Customers in QuickBooks Online are known as your donors, sponsors, building tenants, committee members, grant entities, and just general membership if you are a membership association. To create a new customer, click on the new customer green button at the top right hand corner. Now this customer information screen is where you need to enter information about your donors, information about your committee members, information about your grants, such as address, contact information, also including a copy of the grant letter, information about your sponsors. If you are a church, I do recommend creating your church committees or the key departments of your church or the ministry departments. I do recommend creating them as a customer in QuickBooks Online. One of the cool things about QuickBooks is when you start entering any information in the company name field, it will automatically try to search for that business in Dun's and Bradstreet database. So here you want to enter your company name or your customer name, and you can complete the first and last name fields if you want to. Under the address field, you can enter the billing address information. So if you are using a third-party external donor system to track your donations, I do recommend creating that external system as a generic customer name in QuickBooks, because you're going to track a lot of your donations in lump sum sales receipts. So you do need to have a customer name and not necessarily put all of the individual donors' name all again inside of QuickBooks Online. You don't have to repeat that information. So you could enter Servant Keeper as an example, which is an external donor system. So you can enter it there, and you can enter the billing address. Since this is a generic one, I'm not going to complete some of the other top fields. Under the notes section, I do recommend entering notes about your customers, such as, do they have a special invoicing or billing requirements that you have to follow, especially if you are entering grants and sponsorships? Are they renewal dates that you have to keep in mind? So you can use the notes fields to include anything that is special about this customer, or anything that doesn't have a designated field at the top, you can use the notes section. The tax info, this is great if you are dealing with a lot of customers that you have to charge sales tax to. Here you can enter their tax exemption details. Mark and see, you know, are they a customer that you have to collect taxes from, and what state are you collecting taxes for them, or what state are they located in. The payments and billing tab, here you can set the preferred payment method of this particular customer. So you could choose credit cards, check, or cash here, depending on, you know, how the customer pays you, or you could just leave it blank. You could set the preferred delivery method for this customer. So if you tend to print out the customer invoice, you could do print later. If you tend to email the customer information later on, you could do it. I typically recommend choosing none for that option. Under the terms, this is if your customer has a very specific terms that you can only invoice them net 30, especially if you're dealing with grants and sponsorships, so you can choose that option there. Opening balance field, do not enter anything in that field at all. Just leave that blank. Under the attachment section, this is where you can attach as many documents as you want. So you can attach a grant award letter, you can attach a sponsorship agreement. The additional information field, this is only used if you are keeping track of your donors and different members in QuickBooks Online. So if this is a way of segmenting your donor list, or your customer list, I should say, inside of QuickBooks Online. Once you go through that process, just click Save to complete and record the customer name. If you are tracking grants or sponsorships with multiple award years, create the grant or sponsorship entity as a parent customer and add each grant or sponsorship award year as a sub-customer. So I am going to show you how to do that right now. So in the company field, I am going to create John Foundation as my grant parent company, or I should say parent customer, and repeat the same process that I did in the prior tutorial. Now I'm going to create the award year of the grant or the sponsorship as a sub-customer to that parent company that I just created called John Foundation. So I'm just going to enter the year and say John Foundation, so 2018 John Foundation. And I'm going to check the box that says is sub-customer and then pick the parent company. You have an option of saying bill with parent or bill this customer separately. So I'm going to choose bill with parent. And the screen will automatically fill in all of the parent information in the remaining fields. So this year's grant will be underneath the parent company, the parent company name in QuickBooks Online. Just click save, and that's it. Here's the parent and the sub customer that we created in QuickBooks. That is how to utilize the sales center and add your nonprofit customers in QuickBooks Online. Thank you for watching.